to what about Liam Plunkett makes important as a wicket taker in the middle overs?
I think just bowls straight, obviously mixes pace well, and that cross seam seems to be doing something for him. I don't think anyone else got that sort of movement. Maybe Mark would later on in the
innings. Break it down as a layperson. What does cross seam do? What does it exactly do?
There's inconsistency, obviously. If it hits the seam, it'll behave differently. If it hits the shiny portion, it'll behave differently. Or the one where it's scuffed up, that might behave differently. So, batsmen can't gauge what pace it's coming at. And there was a little bit of movement, whether that was because of the slope that Lords has, or it was just genuinely hitting good lengths and ball doing something off the surface. We'll probably find out a bit more. But just kept plugging away, I think. The consistency in lines was pretty good once he came on. I think didn't start that well, but after that third over, looked a lot better when he changed ends.
And I think the thing that embellishes that cross seam is how tall he is. He's 6'5", 6'6", and he sort of jumps high and he sort of thumps it into the wicket. And I think that tends to produce something a little bit different to as opposed to the skiddy bowler who bowls cross seam. So Ajit's exactly right. It's sometimes it hits the shiny side, sometimes it hits the seam. And I think on a couple of those wickets, it hit the seam and almost set up. And so the guys that were slightly hovering back in their crease just pushed at it and they were almost too soon on it, and that produced nicks or false shots like Henry Nichols. So he just does a fantastic job through his middle stages.
So does that make you as a batsman sustain your crease? I'm looking at Guptill to Chris Wokes, albeit Henry Nichols to Plunkett, Williamson, Ross Taylor to Mark Wood. Everyone's sort of just not sure whether they want to go front or back.
I think it makes you unsure more than anything, because you're worried about one skidding on and keeping low, so you just hover in that crease. And so the wicket has to play a part in that as well. And I think that's what New Zealand will be hoping, that the wicket played a part in how well Plunkett bowled, not taking anything away from him. But they've got similar sort of bowlers in Ferguson trying to thump into the deck. Henry later on, even Neesham, who is a big tall guy as well. They hopefully will get similar sort of results out of the wicket.
Essentially what you're saying is that New Zealand will defend this then, if they've got four bowlers.
You haven't asked me if 240s enough,
bowl,
of course.
Bowl like Leo, this is well over par. This is more than Sri Lanka ever got against England at Headingley on another wicket that seemed a bit hard. But speaking of Liam Plunkett and how efficient and prolific he's been in the middle overs for England, we're looking at the most wickets between overs 11 and 40 for a pace bowler in ODI since the last World Cup. And here you have Liam Plunkett with 57 wickets. So he's right up there ahead of Hasan Ali. Well, surprise, surprise. Guess who's in number three? Hardik Pandya.
Yeah, an incredible average actually because of the way the rules are. You know, five fielders in the ring. So it's a hard time to bowl, not like before where another fielder could go out. So, I mean, I was of the opinion that Moeen Ali should be playing. But since Plunkett played that game against India in particular and on that pitch, of course, the ball gripped the surface a little bit more. We know exactly why he's playing for England. And that record tells you, you know, wickets in the middle of the innings are so crucial. It just felt like New Zealand started to get going and England just kept picking a wicket.
And it feels like they're important wickets as well. Yes. It's either a top order that's set and going hard and he comes in and puts pressure on them, or he gets best batsmen out in the middle. And obviously Kohli's prime example of that, Williamson. So they're not only leading wicket takers, but they're leading wickets in terms of the quality of player that he tends to get out.